when we start to boot, we can also then connect to the console device. And the reason I'm doing the command, as you can see there on the right-hand side, the semicolon and then the zlogin, is that the zlogin happens immediately. The prompt comes back from the boot command. And I don't miss anything coming out on the console. That will continue for a while. The numbers that you can see racking up there are something called the Service Management Facility, SMF, that is, service manifest imports. All the system services, you know, cron, printing, what have you, NFS server, etc., etc. All the system services that run on the system are defined in XML files, which are imported once only the first time the system is booted after an install. Once the system has configured itself, it may actually reboot. While that's going on, there we can see an inconsistency in the boot archive. That's a fairly standard thing for some reason, but it will come back and reboot perfectly okay. I don't know whether it's a bug or whether it's just a feature. While that's happening, let me show you another terminal window. Here's a kernel zone boot after an install on a machine that doesn't have the operating system management tweaks that I talked about and that I'll describe very shortly. And you can see it's failed. There's not enough space. There may be, but maybe the ZFS arc cache didn't get trimmed quickly enough. Okay, so the system is now coming up. Okay, and the system has now entered the configuration tool. Okay, if I press F2, I can then enter my machine name. I'll call it Woody, without a capital, actually. F2. Manually configure the network. I won't bother with DNS at the moment, or any other name services. Continue quickly with the rest of the configuration. I'm in England. Date and time. Keyboard, very important. UK English. Otherwise my pipes and my quotes will get mixed up. Root password. I don't want an optional account. I don't want to register with Oracle, although I could. And I don't need to specify a proxy server because I'm not registering with Oracle. Okay, and that's the configuration completed. Now when I press F2, it goes back to the remainder of the boot process for my new zone. And very shortly that will come up with the login prompt. And I can log in and start configuring, start adding my applications and so forth.